C4 joins us on a Thursday afternoon. A couple of things we want to get to. We'll start here at home. There was kind of a built-in irony to the fact that the mayor was at the funeral for one cop who'd been shot on the line in the line of duty last night and had to leave immediately and go to the hospital where another one had been shot.
Fortunately, a non-fatal shooting.
Yeah.
Fortunately, it was a situation where you had also another officer on the scene that was able to capture the perpetrator in this situation and shot a 30-year-old police officer in the hand. Only to find out, Bill Vanko, that this person that was arrested is a poster child for everything we talk about.
Mm-hmm.
Multiple felony convictions. He himself, the shooter, had been shot three times
in the past.
He's been
on both sides of this. He's been the bad guy and the victim.
But this makes the case over and over again of why are people like this on the street? Why don't we have a way of corralling them? So we had the Mayor Catherine Pugh, on the show today. One of the things she said, she's setting up a meeting with the judges specifically to talk about many of the things that you and I have talked about. So that meeting, she told us, is upcoming. Very shortly.
All these fingers have been pointed at the judges for many months now, and they seem to be rather immune to it.
They're supposed to be. I mean, the way our system of justice is set up, the judge is supposed to be, as an independent arbiter, kind of above the fray. So I do think it's unfair to try to politicize
them. But when they become part of the problem,
that's the difference. Or part of the lack of explanation. One of the things I have consistently said, because judges do come down to Annapolis, they came in front of my committee, Bill, to testify on raises, to testify on different policy proposals, whether there should be more sentencing in one area or another. But they seem to be resistant to answering questions about their activities. Now, you don't have to talk about a specific case to talk about a general policy. If you have a multiple felon with a violent repeat offender, why is that person on the street? To me, that is a question they should be able to answer without jeopardizing their jurisprudence, whatever they want to call it.
That's a question that if we could answer, there'd be a much different situation in the city. Real quick, I want to switch to the national stage because we have this weird political dynamic right now where the representatives of Roy Moore, the Senate candidate in Alabama, the Republican Senate candidate, are going off on Mitch McConnell, the leader of their own party. And now the lawyer for John Conyers, the Democratic congressman
from Michigan, Nancy Pelosi,
is blasting the leader of his party, Nancy Pelosi, because she wants him to resign.
It's amazing.
The parties are eating themselves
from
inside.
What I think we're watching, though, right now, the private sector has found a way with this whole issue of sexual harassment and unwanted sexual advances to immediately deal with it. Before, there might have been time, but now they're immediately dealing with it. The public sector is taking a long time to figure out how to do this. So now we're seeing the public sector attempt to immediately deal with it through leadership. The leadership is saying, we want you to resign, right? The person that's been charged or alleged to have done this is saying, no way, I'm not doing it. The question is going to be...
Well, his lawyer asked the question then, why me, why not Al Franken?
Well, okay, let's give that. But at the end of the day, what happens next? Is there a move by Congress, House and Senate, to have a mechanism to remove members? That's the next thing. Will there be expulsion attempts? At the end of the day, you can't fire them. They're not an employee. So what do you do if they say, no, I'm not going to resign? What do you do?
I hate these days when you and I ask all these questions and don't have any really good
answers. That's why we're the next day to listen for radio. That makes the news, Bill Vanko. That's the ultimate tease.
C4 will be back tomorrow from 9 to 1 here on WBAL News Radio 1090.